Hi, and welcome to Kids Workshop. Last time in episode 8, we still had some trouble with the sound. 21 minutes into the video, the sound disappeared, and why, I don't know. Those USB drivers have always been kind of tricky, but today I will keep an eye on it a little more, and I have a headphone in here so I can hear if it records with it. But that aside, then I apologize for taking so long before I got on again, because I have been sick the whole month. Came after another. I got sick with one thing, and then I get sick with the next, and now I have pneumonia. So that's what happened. So, but this time we will. Now I will remove this one there. So you see, I got to finish our Trebuchet, or that's what we are gonna build. And I know, if you look at it, it looks a little bit complicated, but it isn't. It's because if you try to take it all in at once, with all the up and downs and crosses and whatnot and wheels, and complicated, but as you know, I always try to make it so that everyone can participate, and it's only sticks cut in different lengths and put together, so it's not that complicated. But before we build it, I will give a little warning. This one, even as small as this one is, it gives a pretty pretty punch. Do not put stone in as I did here, because this one, when I fired this off, it made it. I put it in the one end of the studio, and then I shot across the room, and it put a dent in the door. So do not. Of course, it all depends on how heavy a load you put in the bucket here behind. But it will take a little while before we get to that part. But don't aim it at anyone. That's forbidden. You don't use stone as I have hanging here, but I don't have anything else, because I use the stone to glue on top of this, so it looks a little more. I know you better can see it in the other camera. Let's see, we will move the camera a little around in this episode here, because you can see, not that way, we will focus on it. You can see the stone down there. Just to make it to look nice, because that what they would have done in the olden days, but in the Middle Ages when they used stuff like this. But I have copper in the, I have used from the old cooler on a computer I built once. That's not in use anymore, but. You can see it's kind of nice. I think it's a fun thing to build. But if you follow along, and you see, then it will not be that complicated. If we take it one step at a time, and then you can always see if you look in pixelfantasy.com on my site. You can always see the drawings and not drawings, but the pictures of how to do it and what material used and that sort of thing. And you can always see the video afterwards, because you can download it, you can see it on, it will always be up there on my site, and of course on YouTube too, but on my site, and you can see and follow along and pause the video so you can get all the details along the way. This is functioning this way. How do I do this? I go on the other side. So this is how a trebuchet function. You can see it's like a catapult of a kind. When you draw this down, then you take this up, and this is heavy. So when you release it, when it's all the way down, now I'll show you, we take it easy, see. Then the idea is, I'll go on the other side. This is because the camera. I think I will put a camera up above to next time. I hope I can manage that, but not tonight. Then you take this one out, or you first you can do this. Put this string over it, rope over it, and then there is a releaser on this side. So, and then you can take this off, and when you draw the release on the other side, oh no, I forgot one thing. Then there is a kind of a kind of a slisk, we call it. Well, I don't know what you call it. Slide tray that it's slide in, and then this loose part here. If you can see that, it's hard to see on my monitor how much you can see, but then you draw that. Now I will stop it before it goes wild. Then you take this, and now there is a lot of weight on that, and it will go up and over, and the stone will go this way, and it will shoot that way, and this will release, and now you cannot see it because it's so high. Beep. You can see the stone will go this way, and if you build this big enough, you will be able to take your family car and throw it into the next county. So, but this one will not do that, and I guess you will get in trouble with your parents too, so, and we need them to to finance the tools and stuff. So better be on the ah. Better to be on the good side of them in this case. How clumsy can I be? Probably a lot. So now we will let it go up a bit again. And in the middle ages, I hope we will do it again. We need a camera guy here. You can see in the Middle Ages, the plan was, this is very big in real life. Yeah, not this one, but when they built it as a war machine, then they had some people in here to in both sides, and then they crawled like in a hamster wheel, and then they could draw up all that weight. Because there was a lot of weight in that box there. That was, you can see, it's kind of the same as a battery. All the energy is stored in this one when you throw it up. All the energy a man use moving it up, drawing it up, is stored in that box then. And then when you release it, all the power and the weight of the stone will come flying with what there is. But I think this is so they could crawl up here, and there like a lid on both sides, so they could go up and attach this one here. So I love that kind of machinery, and it's kind of the same as this one in another version, because as you see, this one here, you store the energy in the string down there, because you twist it, and then you make the energy while you're twisting the string, and then that was the wrong one. Here we'll draw this down, and there is no ammo in it, so I can release it, and when I can do this side here, and when I draw the pin here, then it, and that can fly pretty long too. But you can see there's stored much more energy in that one than there is in this one. But yeah, they used it so they could put the big one, so they could smash the wall to the city where they want to get in, or they put something burning tar and something like that over the walls into the houses in the city, the city that was surrounded by walls, big walls. So, but we will take it one simple step at a time, and so we are sure that when we are finished with this, you have one of those standing around. So move it a little over here, and you can have pretty much fun with it, I think. So First we will talk about the materials, because we will, sorry, going in front of the camera. Oops, I'm going this way. There are not much space in here, so, but I guess you haven't either, so that may be the same. First, you of course, we cannot do anything. We always have to spend a little bit of money, not much, but a little bit. And this, we need to have some square sticks like this one. And this one is 9 times 9 millimeters in square. This is not actually 100% square, but it's supposed to be. But when you buy it, that's not always the case. Those we need some more, and this one is how long is it? I will take another way around. Wish me a cameraman for Christmas. Then I didn't have to think about it. And I keep an eye on the mic all the time so I can see if we can hear anything. This is a little more than a meter long. It's 1 meter and 20 centimeters long. And I'm reckon you use 12 of those, but I will write down how much material you use, and you can see it on my site. But and these are not expensive. Of course, if it's only your allowance, then it's a little expensive. Maybe, but it cost, I don't know in what country you're in and what, but in my, it will be, we can say in dollars, that will be about $1 or $1.50 a piece. And you need 12, I would say 12 now. 12 of them, and then you need something like this, a round one. This those I have in here, but I think the cheapest way you can do that is to buy a grill stick. They have them in Walmart or where you are buying stuff. And you need some, there are, this are 5 millimeters long, and then you need some thinner ones. I will go get some of those. And you can see those are grill sticks. They are, and they are not more than 2.5-3 millimeters thick. And those I have used, in the wheel. You can see if I change the camera. You can see I've used them in the wheel there. So your knees, they are in smaller bags. there may be hundreds in one. They are very inexpensive too. And then I go and get that. Just a moment, please. Okay. Oh, where are that? Yep, I found it. And then you need some string, and you can see that's just some ordinary cheap string. You put on, and I used a little bit of leather here as kind of like if you made a slingshot yourself, something you can use whatever material you want, but I thought that leather looked a little nicer, but that depends what you think. And then you only need some, if I can get over there. I cannot. On this side, then I'll find it from another side. I'll take this one too. And you need some, this is ordinary white wooden glue, and this is indoor wooden glue, and I have filled it in a little container like this, so it's easier to manage, so you don't have it's harder to mess around with a big one. So now it comes to the tools. Because what you saw here is everything that's in there. There's not wood, round sticks, a little piece of leather, a string, and some grill sticks, and the rest are made out of the same wood as this one. So I don't think there is anything else. Oh yes, I have a little piece of flat wood here. I forgot that piece. I'll show you that. That's kind of like this one. But you also, when you I have glued two of these together side by side, so but this one is 2 centimeters at 20 millimeters, and I glued two of those side by side, and then I have a little square one here too that are 6 times 6 millimeters, but then that's all. But you can read it all on my site when what you are gonna use. It's not up yet, but it will come. I'll see if I can do it tomorrow. But there are pictures of this up there tomorrow already now. So that was that part, and now we come to the tools. Of course you can make this yourself, but they are so cheap to build, so if you gonna if you are going to buy the wood for it, then it will cost the same as you buy them, so finished. It's a kind of a cut box. We call it a cut box here, directly translated, but I don't know what you call it. But it's so you can cut these in a right angle. You can cut it 45 degrees and you can cut it right over. So that's a must have. And you can get them in plastic too. So, and maybe you prefer that. And they are also very cheap. So, a little. Then you need a saw. I of course have a machine to do it, but you don't, so I guess you don't. But and this is a saw with a small piece on it, as you can see, like this, and a tall blade. And the reason for the tall blade is that it's easier to hold right in the in the, what do we call it? Now I can the cut tracks here. You know what I mean. So it's just an ordinary one with a small blade, then it will wiggle around in here. So you need it. And then the small seeds are necessary for when you cut something, like they are very small too, because otherwise it's very, now you need to make this stable on the table. I'm not standing right. You see, it's good to do this. So, what it will be, you have to fasten it to the table, and then you have to fasten the things you are sawing. But you will see that when, because I will do it mostly in the same way as you will do it, because I have done this with the machine, so just to get it done in a hurry, because it had taken too long because I've been sick. So the saw and the glue, that's what you need, and the box here, this you need. And then I will, and of course some of these will be nice, but they are a little more expensive. But if you go and look in the garage, then your father maybe, or your mother maybe, have one of those or two. That's nice to fasten stuff like this, and it's easy when you are on your own. I'm standing a little side. So and then in one in the other end too, and then it don't run anyway. Well, but if you don't have one of these and not can afford to go buy it, then some of these smaller ones, and those you can of course get in every variation, and that's it's not important who made them. It's just important to have them, and they are also cheap. So as many as those you have, the better. And always remember, the tools you buy, you have forever if you are good to it, and you can make tons of. It's only the first time you have to go and buy stuff like this. When you have bought it, then you can make thousands of things with it. So it's I know you wish for Christmas, you wish a new iPad or a new tablet or a new laptop or new phone, but maybe your little sister, your little brother can give you one of these in or two in Christmas gift, and that's a good thing. And then some tools that's very good to have too. If you don't have the one I show you, these are even cheaper and are really good. You have to have a strong grip to open these. So they are good to fasten. And then a lot of these small, you buy them in a tube like, and they are, I don't know, 50 of these or 25 or something. There's a lot of those in such a tube, so, and cheap, so, and that I think is all you need to make this, and you can say that's a lot of tools. It actually is not. So I will put this over again. And I'll remove this. And now I move you to tripod. Tripods fill a lot, but we can't live without them. So so the first we will do when we do things like this is we'll start making the bottom frame here, and you can see, maybe you could, but it's kind of two of this one is not a nice sort. See, when you buy these sticks here, then be careful to look at them. I have not done it. Sometimes they has kind of destroyed them, and when I saw them out. So we take the good end. You can see they are kind of two up on each other, and but first we just make a single one, because you can, I guess you can, or else we will So but you can see that the tower, the stick from the towers goes down, and then in real life it would have been a little more complicated because we would have kind of tapped those into each other, but you don't have the tools for that, and then they get expensive. So we do it this way, and then it looks good, and it's very strong. So we do it this way, and this is in the way. It's always best to put the tool in place after use, but sometimes we forget. So, and now I tip it a little so you can see. There are two, like, oops, I cannot put, see. You can, oh, yes, there it is. And it's easier to see. You, you can see there are sticks between the two frames here. This one and this one, and there are sticks between here to keep the distance between them, and then you lay the kind of what do we call it, slide something on here. So the first thing we will do is to cut. We will do the measurement, how, and I'll put the measure, I'll put it in here, in there, and I know it's 60, but just to, where are you? You are not there anymore. Then we will go a little further back. Even more. You can see it's 60. So what we need is to make two of these 60 millimeters long. And if you are from US, you of course reckon in inches, but then you just you can Google millimeters to inches. So it's easy to do that, or get somebody to help. It's not that complicated. Oh, turn it the right way. And make a little mark. And by the way, that is one little more thing I would like you to have. That's I will go out here a little, and then I have a pencil in my mouth so you can hear what I say. But I will what would you maybe call it, an angle iron or something like that, and so that's the only thing that's a little thing you have to be a little careful about is not with that button frame here, but when you come to all the other things, it's you are careful making the angles right, but that not just be as precise as you can all the time, because it will, if you are, oh, that don't mean anything, we that's good enough and that's good enough and that's good enough, if you do that all the way through, then you will get, it will be not that good at. I want you to be proud of what you have done when we are finished, or when you are finished. But you can see 6, and I have only one here. Let's go, now we see if the bad one here is good enough to. To 60, or when it start to get. Oh, gee, what's the bad one I had? Okay. So, and then we use this one. To cut it precise, I need to move a little thing away here. So we can have our. And then. I'll use one of these. Because you need to. It's a little difficult here because you can see the table edge are round. And it's easier if you have one that is not round. It's much easier then. Now we need to, because we will saw both at the same time. And then we have a mark. The mark is here and down here. Because now you don't have to chase it all over the place. Now I will move this a little bit. And maybe I will do like this. And then I will use the other camera for this so you can see what we are doing. No. And there are no light down there, so you cannot see anything. But light there will come. Let there be light, I mean. Yes, now you can see. And I will move this camera in. See? Now? Take it easy and let the saw do the work. Don't try to push it through. That is okay. Cut the light again. I didn't change the camera, did I? I'm the worst camera operator ever. But I saw it. So now I have both sides here. And we will put two like this and keep an eye on the sound. So and then, of course, I cannot use this. Can you see? This stick is much slimmer than this one. I hate this when I do like that. But 120 and 60, that's the same thing, isn't it? That's, see, I was in luck. See, those are the same, because the stick was 120 long and I used 60. So, they were not that precise, I can see, but we will make it precise. You can see it's kind of stepping in, but they are at least so we need to cut one more time, and this time maybe you can see what I'm doing, because I use the right camera. But you will always get in that kind of small situations that something don't fits because, not always because of you, but because of those who have cut the sticks in the sawmill. I will go to the other camera and then I will move that one so you can see what I'm doing. See, that was the camera I thought I had you on right before, and then we'll put some light in here. Not that heavy light, because then when I like this. Then you better can see. So another hand. Oops. I'm extremely clumsy today. Shall we try again? And we have still have some. It's marvelous. I probably have forgotten something else, but so let's hope it's right this time. It should be. It should be. So now we have two of these, and these. Now we will close this one. Oh, up. And I will not this time make a lot of it. We are on again Thursday, so I will not make a lot of it until Thursday. I will, when we stop just where we are, and then we keep on from there Thursday, so that you can follow it all the way through. So it's not like this chef you see in the cooking program in telly where he make dinner for a million people in 6 seconds. That's not the case here. We will not do that. Maybe we'll do like this. Because this is not virtual reality, it's really a reality. I know virtual reality is in right now, and that's pretty amazing too, but we don't make reality to fantasy, we make fantasies to reality. That's another whole another thing. So we will, the next, now we will use, remember that this stick is the same height as this one, and the distance I have made between these two rails here, that eventually ends up as a frame to it, it's 7 millimeters. 7 centimeters is seven. No, 8, is it? Maybe. No. Okay. Yeah. Then 8. Then we get. So, what we need to make. That's. Some there are of these. There are 8. Eight long, and there are 1. You can, I will put this here so you can see. There are, I don't think of that one. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In total, 6, and then there are 2 round sticks, one in this end and one in the other end, because, as you will see, we turn it out around the other way. We have the string going under the button here from one end to the other to make the crane here, or what shall we call it, this mechanism to load the trebuchet. So here, but these two are finished, and then we need to cut some more of these, but we were not that happy with them, you know. So the one of them, I will see if I can get some more. Because I bought many. See, you will not have those that don't have the right size. But all of these are good. Because when we have to look them through a little. Of course, when we, it's irritating when you have been sawing and doing stuff, and then you have to cast them, throw them away afterwards. That's not. You don't throw anything away. You can always use a little bit, something somewhere. Right. See, we have a lot of them here, and we decided they should be 8, starting this end. Today I have headphones in here. They are in the way. So then I do not prefer to draw after this one. I prefer to have a little ruler like this one, because it's kind of more accurate, but it's easier to handle. And I am a graphic designer, so I prefer this tooth. Eight. Eight. That was not that precise. Try to be as precise as possible all the times. Then you get the best result. There's always thing that's not get that accurate down the line, but start out doing everything as accurate as possible. And measure twice and cut once. 8 centimeters, 80 millimeters. If I just took, I forgot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. So, if I had 2 more, I could cut them all at once. At once. And you could too. And I have but now we have to think, because if we have to measure how long is this one, because we used 2 for that one, and it is, no, that's under 60. That's only 5 because if this was longer and then I have gotten all over, then I didn't have a stick left that was long enough for, if I have, but you can see, always trying to think ahead. But we have again used an hour, so your assignment to next time is go and buy some nine times 9 millimeters sticks, and then we can follow along with the build. We have made this, and next time we cut this one, and then we start to glue this together. Then we have the frame and so on, and it's don't think it's more complicated than it is, but it, I know it looks kind of a little complicated, but it isn't. It just looks that. Never be afraid. So I will say thank you guys, and we'll see you next time, and this will be episode number 8, because I will delete the another episode 8 I have up, because there are only sound in 21 minute in, so I will throw the other one out, and this will be episode 8. Okay, thank you.